Welcome back down to my basement. We have got two really cool basses for you to check out today, both from Ibanez in the Artcore range, the AGB200, and we're also going to be looking at the AGB260 in just a moment. Now, as usual, we'll get up to the top of the bass, work down the neck, listen to some of the tones when we get down to the body, and then we'll switch over to the 260 and you can compare that. So here we go then. For those of you who like something a little bit different, some different styling versus our usual precisions and our jazzes and basses like that, something a bit cool, maybe a bit retro, this I think is pretty tasty. Up at the headstock then, two aside tuning keys, and I'm going to flip the bass over as usual and we'll have a little lick around the back, like so. Nice small tuning keys with these nice white pegs on them. Gives it that sort of really cool vintage look, doesn't it? Down the back of the neck, which I understand is a three-piece maple and niato. I actually had to look up niato. Apparently it is an Indonesian hardwood, but I can't tell you a great deal more about that. Super, super nice skinny neck. And as I look further down the body, you can see that we've got a set neck glued in and then down onto the body here. And I'm just going to roll the bass over so you can see that we've also got a bound neck. And actually, as we go around, you'll see that actually the whole body is bound as well. Like so. Fretboard on this particular beast is laurel. And actually, if you look really closely, I love some nice colour differences in there as well. You see like the darker lines in there, and actually I think that's really interesting. You know, don't get me wrong, I really like a kind of like a big naked board with no markers or anything. But I also like something with a bit of texture. Nothing looks really, really nice. The neck feels very, very skinny. It is super nice in the hand, and the action on this particular example is nice and low as well. Coming down the fretboard, really nice finished fretwork, medium-sized frets. So if you're used to something a bit more jumbo, then you're going to want to give this a bit of a workout. For me, actually, I actually prefer medium-sized frets. They feel quite nice under the fingers. And as I come down the 22 fretboard, we are onto the body, which, have a closer look at this. I'll roll it forward again, and you can see that we've got this kind of sort of pseudo hollow body thing going on. And we have got maple for the top, sides and back. Looks really, really nice. I'm just roll the bass forward and you can see that lovely glossy finish. And again, the grain looks super, super nice around the back, like so. Just a moment to note the strap pegs as well, strap buttons rather. And there's no sort of compartment holes or anything like that. No black plastic with screws in it around the back here. So it looks really, really nice and neat. Okay, round we go. Back onto the front of the instrument. Two pickups, very, very nice indeed. I love these chrome tops. I think that looks really nice with the hardware. One right up against the fretboard. So you're going to get a nice, warm, almost kind of that lovely sort of EB kind of bass tone. I like that. And then a bit of a sharper attack going on with a pickup closer to the bridge. In my introduction, you actually saw me switch from the front pickup to the bridge pickup and had a listen to the sounds out of those. And I think they are particularly useful. They sound really, really good. Onto the bridge, a two-piece Gibraltar setup here. Again, quick release, so you can get these strings in and out nice and quickly. And then coming around to the electronic side of things, it's all passive. No batteries on this bad boy. Master volume, nice kind of like numbers around the dial, and also a master tone. We'll listen to that in just a moment. And then a three-way switch. So front pickup, rear pickup, or in the middle position, you're going to get a mix of the two. Nice F holes here as well. And because the bass is pretty much hollow, it is also very, very light. Okay then, we'll do the usual. Let's have a listen to the front pickup, listen to the rear pickup, and then we'll have a listen to that tone control. And then we're going to grab the 260 and you can have a listen to that as well. Okay, so front pickup. This bass, I don't know if I want to slap it. I feel bad. So let's do it. See something really nice about that. It's got loads and loads of bottom end to it. Pick style on the front pickup. Let's mute it actually. I feel like I'm in like some sort of American car chase movie from the 60s with this tone. It's very, very cool. Let's go over to the bridge pickup. I won't slap it this time. Let's go to fingerstyle. I like this. I've noticed that actually on the bridge pickup, there's still quite a lot of low mid range. And on a lot of basses like jazz basses, you get that lovely top end. But there's an extra bit of warmth in there. Maybe it's just a setup today, but it does sound really, really nice. So get some decent earphones on, get some decent speakers around this and see if you can hear it as well. I think it sounds really nice. Yeah, I like that, actually. I really like that. Let's go back to the position which I used in my opening playthrough. I've gone to both pickups on. Let's slap it. I still feel bad. I also feel quite awkward about slapping it as well, because whilst I was doing that, I realized that my finger was kind of not expecting a pickup to be there, but it's doable. I think it sounds really, really nice, actually. Although it does feel a little bit odd. I feel like I'm, you know, doing something I shouldn't be doing on this particular instrument. It sounds really nice, though. There's a lovely body to the sound in the low end by having this pickup so close to the fretboard. Let's dial out that top end and go all the way back with the tone control. Extra low end, I've also gone for the front pickup, again with the tone control all the way back. Ah, it's nice. Got a bit carried away there, but I really like that low end. It's got a nice rumble to it. Still lots of character in there, and I'm not losing too much top end by actually rolling that tone control all the way back. Really like it, actually. Feels nice, action's nice and low, it's nice and lightweight. Look, no hands, it is sitting absolutely still, so it's a very well balanced instrument as well. Well, I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's put this one down, we'll get the 260 out and have a little listen to that as well. Thank you. And here we have it. This is the AGB260, finished in this rather gorgeous sea foam green. The 200 model only comes in natural. The 260 comes in this lovely finish. Underneath, actually very, very similar in terms of both basses, but they actually sound completely different. Whereas the 200 had maple, top and sides and back, we've got Sapele for this top, sides and back. Again, bound, we should just have a quick look at that. And the same neck. Oh no, my mistake, this is Niato for the neck. There is no maple in this one. And yes, it does. It sounds completely different. We'll have a quick listen. But first of all, I'm just going to roll the bass over so you're going to have a look at the backside, as it were. There we go, coming around. And there's our binding. Binding on the side of the fretboard. Again, the same set neck on this one. This time, no wood grain to see, just this lovely spance of glossy finish. Absolutely blemish free. Very nice indeed. Coming back. Looks like this one's got pick guard, nice kind of sort of pearly looking thing. Again, same quick release bridge, same pickups, same electronic settings, same switch, but it does sound really different. So this is finger style on both pickups, and we'll just zoom through these, and we'll do the pickups individually as well. Seems to have a even more kind of a phased sound between the two pickups. Now this one, the action feels like it's set just a little bit on the low side. That would be easy to adjust, you know, when you got your new instrument home. So there's a little couple of rattles on this one, but I wouldn't say that was anything particularly scary to sort out. Okay, right, front pickup on its own. Here's fingerstyle. A really nice character to that pickup. Still very full, but it definitely has a very particular colour to it. It just sounds a bit more interesting than maybe, you know, like a bland precision bass pickup, for example. Let's switch over to the back pickup. Do the same again. Couple of little buzzes there. It sounds really nice. I think it doesn't sound quite as full as the 200. Maybe, you know, it's just the differences between the two basses. Still, very, very usable sound. Let's go and listen to both at the same time. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll the tone off so we can see how much of that low rumble we can get out of the bass as well. Here we go. Yeah, good, good, very, very nice. Again, nice and rounded. You could rumble away in maybe a, you know, a jazz quartet or something like that. Nothing too offensive there, but a really nice sort of color to the sound as well. Yeah, I really like this one. It's a quite nice little machine. So that's pretty much it for the two basses. We've been through a range of the sounds, and I've talked about the actual feel of the bass. Again, nice and lightweight. This one sits perfectly still on my lap. If you're looking to do long gigs, then you're going to enjoy this as well, because it's nice and lightweight, being a nice hollow body. So to wrap up, I will, as usual, put some stuff, more written information into the magazine article. Please don't forget to go over and read that. And I will catch up with you in a new review very soon. Thanks ever so much for watching. See you again.